We're here today with Alec Snell, the Southland 800-meter champion. He's going to take us through one of the craziest races we saw in the conference championship weekend. We'll get it started just playing behind us here, Alec. You're stepping the line pretty loose. You won prelims the day before, kind of pretty handily. You made sure you were in the right spot to do that. What is going through your mind when you're stepping the line to take on the field in this 800-meter championship?
I just want to feel good, get out with the pack, get into a comfortable spot, and just race like I normally do, sit, and when the move is made, go with them.
We'll kind of get into that move that you are referring to there. How'd you like your start, though, as it's playing behind us there? You got out pretty good, kind of found yourself towards the back of the pack on the first little curve there, and then worked your way into the position that we'll talk about right here. But how did you start, and what's kind of going through your mind for a runner, like once you are in the race, you kind of fighting your way through where you are in it?
I would have liked to got out a little faster, but the race played in my hands. Me and Coach Brock knew exactly how it was going to go.
Like I said, you kind of started from the back of the pack here. Pictured here is at 400, which we're going to play through real quickly here just to kind of show everybody where you're at. You fought your way back into that top four, kind of with force to the outside there, and that's a position you stayed in for the rest of the race. What was the thought process there in going outside? Were you just kind of forced there, and what made you kind of stick in that outside position as you guys kept going through?
Going around the last curve, it was just me and two other guys, and the move was made. I had to go with them, and right when we hit that curve, I just slung shot out to the outside, and that's what put me into the position.
And you just touched on it there. We'll kind of show the fans as it plays behind us. It really did turn into a three-person race there as you see the two competitors. What kind of, again, you're holding the outside position. You were not going to get into the finish just yet, which we're about to show people, but kind of what was the move here? You're still on that outside spot, and as you could tell, you're just giving it your all. Was there any strategy at this point, or once you got to that last 80, it's, hey, we're just busting it to the finish?
Like I said, I knew going into it was going to come down to the last 50 meters. Before, I told myself if I had to, I was going to go for it and dive. And it came down to it. It was me and one other guy right there at the end, and I just took flight.
And taking flight is exactly what you did, as we'll play it through here. Diving right through the line. Fans, you're not going to see that in too many races. And you kind of stole the question a little bit beforehand there, but this was something that went through your mind where, hey, if I'm at such and such with another competitor, I'm diving through.
Oh yeah, I definitely thought about that before. A lot of people asked me if it was pre-planned. Definitely was.
And then what, have you ever done that in a race before, anything like that? Or is that just something that came through your mind and you're like, you know what, we're doing it?
Definitely have not done that in a race, but I would do it again to get that conference championship.
And then we'll kind of just let it play out here too. The reaction with your coaches, the teammates, was incredible. What were these couple moments like right here celebrating with the squad?
It was awesome. I mean, none of this would be possible without the teammates, coaches, staff. I wouldn't have got it done. And all props to all of them.
And then I did have to ask about the battle scars here. You can kind of see it in the pictures. It doesn't do it fully justice. His arms beat up, legs got beat up. How bad did those hurt after, kind of like you said, you're conference champion?
Oh, they burned a little bit, got in the shower, put some Vaseline on them, but they're healing up. I'm ready for regionals.
And then you were a former distance guy, and 800 is kind of just at that borderline where it's not a sprint, but it definitely takes a lot of endurance to go around the track twice all out like that. Did that distance side kind of help you in the season we've seen? I mean, you had a great indoor, and now to close out, well, not totally close, you'll be in regionals, but to close out the conference championship with this title, did that kind of help you in your progression this season?
I definitely think the base that Coach Brock has built during the cross country season has helped me in the 800 a lot. And I mean, it was just building strength throughout the cross country season. I knew I wasn't in the top seven guys, but I knew I'd be there for track.
And up until this point, is this one of your best track and field moments?
Definitely. The conference championship is my top moment.
And you'll be able to check out Alec Snell and a couple other UNO Privateer student athletes at the upcoming NCAA Division I East Regionals. Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you.